Well, today I want to talk to you about the fact that God always keeps His promises. And there are thousands of promises in the Bible, and God keeps all of them. None of them fail, and some of them take time. Some of them don't get fulfilled immediately, but God always keeps His promises. Now, in our last devotional, we were talking about those Jewish people returning to Jerusalem after having spent 70 years in Babylonian captivity, and how they began to rebuild that temple, and people opposed them and tried to intimidate them, and they were afraid. And yet, even though they were full of fear, they continued doing what God wanted them to do. And we talked last time, and I talked at some length about the fact that faith is not the absence of fear, but faith is moving forward even when we are afraid. And that's what they did. Now, today, I want to talk about the fact that God always keeps His promises. In the very first verse of the book of Ezra, we read that King Cyrus, who was the king of Persia, and by this time the Persians had defeated the Babylonians, and it says that the word of the Lord, which had been spoken by Jeremiah the prophet, that that word might be fulfilled, God stirred the heart of Cyrus and put it on his heart to issue a proclamation that the Jewish people could go home. Now, what's interesting is many, many years before Cyrus came on the scene and issued that proclamation, God, through Jeremiah the prophet, had made a promise. And the promise was, at the end of 70 years, I'm bringing my people home. And even though it took 70 years for that promise to be fulfilled, indeed it was. And so I want to say to you today, the best thing you could do as you live your life each day is to find and claim a promise from God. The Bible is full of them, and we all have our favorites. And it would be easy for me tonight to share several of my favorites with you. But I don't think that's necessary. The point I'm making is that as Christians, we live our lives not by feelings, not by circumstances, not by how things are going, but we live our lives according to the promises of God. And so today, I would encourage you to find a promise in the Bible. That's why it's so important every day to read the Bible. And when you read it, be looking for specific promises that God has made to you. I'll share one, could share a lot, but one of them, I mentioned Jeremiah, in chapter 29, in verse 11, God said this, "For I know the thoughts that I think toward you, says the Lord, thoughts of peace and not of evil, to give you a future and a hope." God has made a promise that He has a future for you, just like He has a future for me. And He had a future for the Jewish people, even when they were in Babylon. There's a promise. You ought to claim that promise. They say, "God, I thank you that you have good plans for me." The very next verse says, "Then you will call upon me and go and pray to me, and I will listen to you." There's another promise. God said, when we pray, He listens. Sometimes we feel like God's a million miles away. Well, He's not. He's nearer than the air you breathe. He's living on the inside of you in the person of the Holy Spirit. There's a promise you can have today when you pray. Be assured God is listening. And the very next verse has another promise. God said, "And you will seek me and find me when you search for me with all your heart." What a great promise. God says, if we'll seek after Him, we'll find Him. So many of us spend our time seeking things from God instead of seeking God Himself. And yet the promise is, if we'll seek God, we'll find Him. He'll give us what we need, certainly. But God Himself is always better than whatever else He might give us. And so today, claim a promise. How do I know I'm saved? The primary way I know I'm saved is the promise of God that all who call upon the name of the Lord shall be saved. God made that promise to all of us. I've called on the name of the Lord. I believe that promise. I trust God's word, and I know that I'm saved. And so, you know, we began the Christian life by trusting the promises of God, those salvation promises. Jesus said, "The person who comes to me, I will in no wise cast out." That is, He'll always accept us and receive us. So that's a tremendous promise. Believe on the Lord Jesus Christ and you will be saved. That's a promise. Well, I have believed, and God says, since I've believed, I'm saved. Well, I take that by faith. We began the Christian life by trusting in the promises of God. Colossians 2:6 says, "As you therefore have received Christ Jesus the Lord, so walk in Him." And so we continue the Christian life, and one day we will end our life on earth and step out into eternity to be with God in heaven forever. How are we going to do that? By trusting in the promises of God. I think when we come to the very end, the verse that will be very near and dear our heart, just may well be Psalm 23 and verse 6. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever. One of the ministers that impacted my life most when I was growing up, a man named Fred Lewis, who when I was in elementary school in Tennessee was my principal of that school. And years later, when our family moved to East Texas, my dad asked him to move to Sulphur Springs as well and to join the staff, and he did, and worked at that church for almost 40 years. And I learned recently something about Fred I did not know. His favorite verse, Psalm 23:6, surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever. You know what? That's how I want to die. I want to die with Psalm 23:6 in my mind and in my heart. And I want to say to God, God, all my life, goodness and mercy have followed after me. And now that it's coming to an end, I have every confidence that I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever. I'm trusting you, Jesus, to keep that promise. And I hope to just close my eyes and fall asleep and open them in heaven. That's how you die. You begin the Christian life by trusting the promises of God. You continue the Christian life by trusting in the promises of God. And one day we end our lives on earth by trusting in the promises of God. May we die like Joshua died when he said, of all the promises that God has made to me, not one of them ever failed. All of them came to pass. And so today, the word is, trust God's promises, even in some cases, if they take a long time to come true. Have a great day. Look forward to being with you next time. Bye-bye.